All right, quick introduction to the frog simulation for your response question. Happy Friday. So what's going on, similar to the ones we had before, where it's a single free response question you're going to be practicing today. And so you can access the directions right here in this PDF to click on it and read through it. The big thing you got to decide is do you want to write out your answers here or do you want to type them out? Okay, so if you write them out, you can just look at the PDF and you basically got to fill in two methods. Right, so there's the one called simulate, so you just have to fill in what that is and return a Boolean. And then in part B, you have a different method and you just write the heading and fill it in. So you write out those method headings and fill in the code based on the description that's given in here. Okay, and this one's really testing your ability to call different methods. So this is kind of a helpful high-level view of the frog simulation. When you construct it, you've got a goal distance that the frog is trying to hop to. You got the max number of hops they can take to get to that distance. So you can see a constructor they've given us here. They got a method that simulates a hop, and then you have to write these two methods here, right? And you're going to end up having to like this simulate method has to call hop distance, and then I think this run simulations has to call the simulate method. So you're going to have to get them all to work together is what they're really testing you here. So if you want to write it out, again, you just got to fill in these two methods. You don't have to write out the rest of the class, but just fill in the methods and write them out. If you want to do it in Eclipse, just make a new one called Frog Simulation. And then I added this code, right? You don't have to add it by any means. But to make it so you don't get compile errors, added the stuff that they gave me. And then I actually made a hop distance method that returned an int. Sometimes it hops forward, sometimes it hops back. You don't have to do this in the code or anything. You could just have it return five or something, just so it doesn't error out. But again, that's just to get it to compile, really. And then what you actually have to do is write the simulate code, assuming that this hop distance works the way they describe it, and then write the code for run simulation. So that's sort of the setup for it. Again, it's as always, they have little help videos. Try them first, but then if you get stuck on part A, there's a help video on a part B. There's also a help video for that. Completed code can be turned in here or on your Google Drive folder, either by taking pictures or just uploading the actual code if you typed it out. All right, that's it. Let me know if you have any questions.